right, welcome to Fast Eddie's Records. Today we have a vinyl reveal. Very excited about this find. We could not continue with this channel without mentioning the late, the great, the amazing Louis Armstrong. This record was found at Dusty Grooves Records, 1120 North Ashland, Chicago, Illinois. Again, we are tracking this beautiful tune on the sunny side of the street, and what Louis Armstrong made this song more famous probably than any other single figure in music. And his playing of this beautiful song is completely unique, and his voice in music is completely unique. We couldn't continue this channel without talking about Louis Armstrong. So when I found this record, I couldn't be more happy. So this is an amazing vinyl reveal. Let's see what we got here. Okay, it says Satchmo at Symphony Hall, recorded a concert presented by Ernest Anderson in Symphony Hall, Boston, November 30th, 1947. Louis Armstrong was born 1901, August 4th, which is another reason this record means a lot to me. That's actually my anniversary and my brother's birthday. So this record was a really beautiful find for me. So this was recorded in 1946. Let's see here. 1946. At Symphony Hall, recorded, supervised by Peter Fritchie. It has this. It's from Decca Records. It's a two-record set. It's simulated stereo. I don't know if you know what that is. Simulated stereo is they were trying to sell more hi-fi equipment, and they had to do something with all the old mono recordings, and they tried something called simulated stereo. So we're going to see what it sounds like. I imagine it still sounds amazing. So it's Louis Armstrong and the All-Stars featuring Louis Armstrong on trumpet and vocals, Jack Teagarden trombone and vocals, Barney Biggard clarinet, Dick Carey on piano, Sidney Catlett on drums, and Arvell Shaw on bass, and we have Velma Middleton on vocals. So All-Stars, if you guys don't know Jack Teagarden, these guys are amazing characters from early jazz. Louis Armstrong is a direct through line to the beginning of jazz. He is jazz. It's Buddy Bolden. It's him. He's also quintessential New Orleans, one of my favorite cities in the entire world. I love New Orleans. So this record was seriously, I almost got emotional when I found this. I was very happy to find this recording. He has many recordings of this song. He made it famous, so I was bound to find it I was going to find this record for sure. So let's take a look at the inside here. So it's pretty plain. It tells a story here. I'll read it one day and report back what it actually, who wrote the program note. It looks like it was written by Ernest Anderson, London. let's see here. Satchmo at Symphony Hall. It says Louis Armstrong and the All-Stars with everyone it features. And you have two records. Let's see what actual songs are on this record. So we have number one, Muskrat Ramble. Number two, Black and Blue. Number three, Royal Garden Blues. Number four, Lover. Number five, Stars Fell on Alabama. All standards, number side two, we have I Cried for Two, Since I Fell for You, Oh, T for Two. I cannot wait to hear his version of T for Two. I love that song. Body and Soul, another classic, of course. Mahogany Hall Stomp. Again, I haven't heard all these songs, so I can't wait to hear it. On side three, we have Steak Face. Number two, of course, On the Sunny Side of the Street. That's why I bought this record. Number three, we have High Society. Number four, That's My Desire. On side four, Sea Jam Blues. That's going to be amazing. Happy Won't You Please Me Come Home, How High the Moon, and Boff Boff. So Decca, let's take a look at the actual vinyl. The condition is very good. So we have a Decca. Decca has the most beautiful label. I love the Decca label. It's I mean, come on. It's Helvetica font with the beautiful rainbow. It's again, it has all the markings. The actual vinyl looks beautiful. Pretty good condition. You have, again, on this side, you have Steak Face on the sunny side of the street. Three High Society, and That's My Desire. All right, let's take a listen. Wow, unbelievable. I loved that really nice, soft piano intro. You know, he played with a lot of big bands early in his career, so the fact he's with a really small lineup here, you can tell he's pretty, you know, he's like a little further in his career. He was 40, let's see, he was 46 at the time, so yeah, he died at 71. So, it's a really unique, I can't wait to hear, I'm sure I'll hear other versions of this with the big band. I loved this version of it. It was unbelievable. His voice, as soon as it comes in, it's so recognizable. It's what music is. Like, he is the beginning. He's the essence. He you know, when I'm looking for music, I'm looking for something that moves me emotionally first. It's got to move that barometer inside. And his voice, his playing, you know, especially a song like that, it's a happy song, you know, the lyrics, but he brings some real depth and sadness to it because of the times, you know. You know, you can imagine it wasn't very easy for a person like Louis Armstrong to do what he did in the time that he did it. So it was very, very difficult. And the reason it cut through is because he cuts through. His sound cuts through. His trumpet playing, as described early on, had a little, you know, he was a little notier, a little faster playing, a little more, you know, that makes sense. So as you can see, as his career developed, he developed a style that was a little more like you said, like Lester Young, lyrical, beautiful, more potent. So very happy with this record.
Thanks for taking a spin at Fast Eddie's Records.
Like and subscribe.